Hello, Umut here. Welcome to another video. Today I'm going to create a fun page with Elena Zinsky digital stamps. You know I love working with Elena's images because they are so much fun. It just brightens my day. So I picked up my art journal and printed some images. Elena gives options for her images, both colored and uncolored. So when I feel lazy, like today, I print them in color because she colors them so brilliantly anyway. I'm going to give all the links down below to the images that I used from Elena Zinsky shop on Etsy. Two of these images are from different collections. One is from the Toucan collection, one is from the Zodiac collection, but I used it on a sea page. And the girl, the mermaid, is actually a free download if you become a member of Elena's Facebook group. I'm going to leave the link down below to the Facebook group and the free download. So you can go there and actually have it for free. As you realize, in the meantime, I used my dilutions paints in turquoise and blues, and some deco art Americana in light turquoise as well, to create a smooth background with a couple of values, like shades of turquoise color. It really doesn't matter which brand you use, use what you have in your stash. If you have blue, mix it with white a little bit, you will get a lighter color. And just create 2-3 shades of the same color and create a background with your acrylic paints. Today I'm going to use a lot of stencils to create my sea scenery actually. This is a favorite stencil that I have. I printed it, I cut it myself with acetate stencil paper through my digital cutter. I use a silhouette portrait digital cutter. I download available imagery and it cuts for you. I create a lot of stencils like this at some point. But if you Google Waves stencil, there are some brands who have similar stencils as well. I looked for myself. This is another stencil that I cut in the same way. I'm just using different shades of turquoise, again the same paints that I used on my background, to just go over these stencils with my sponge blender. I'm dipping it in the paint a little bit. Don't dip it so much, and make sure you dab it first outside. It needs to be just a little bit, otherwise it seeps underneath your stencil. This is another bubbly stencil. I think it's from Dusty Attic. I'm just giving some texture. Again, use whatever you have in your stash that can be related or not to sea scenery. To create some texture at the back, this will be all at the background. We will use images at the front anyway. And I'm just going to do some splashes with my turquoise color to add to the texture. I love using splashes as part of the texture as well. It just creates a lot of energy and movement. And after it dries, I'm going to use my Arteza paints in light and dark green. To create some plants in the sea. This is my dilutions stencil from several years ago. I think it's one of the first stencils that she had anyway, and it's one of my first stencils when I started art journaling. I'm still in the mindset of using my stash and really not buying so many new stamps or stencils. I didn't buy for years, maybe a couple only, or I used the ones that company sent me to use in my videos. And to make it more interesting, not so dull, I'm going to use the light green to just draw some details that you would see on leaves. In the meantime, I fussy cut my visuals from Elena's digital stamps, and I go around all the elements with black marker just to make sure I don't have the white edges anymore. This crab and there is a fish and scorpion, actually they are from the zodiac stamps to use as zodiac signs, but I looked and I thought, well, why not use them in a sea scenery? After all, they are the animals that we can see in the sea. So I'm pretending they are the crab, the fish and the lobster instead of a scorpion. I decided to give a little bit more color with some red or pink tones with this stencil. This stencil is from Crafters Workshop. Again, it's a very old purchase and I used it several times, so I'm very proud of myself that I made a very good use of it, and it's worth the money I paid. You can create a lot of texture like this with your stencils. Also, if you don't have stencils, you can always draw yourself. These are very simple images: leaves, plants, bubbles. You can use circles, circle elements that you have in your home. It's very possible. If I didn't have it, I would use my brushes and I would just draw it myself. I thought a little bit orange would make a nice pop and contrast. So now I'm finished with the scenery background. I'm going to just glue my images down. I'm using matte medium. My brush is dry and I am very gentle. I am not pressing my brush harshly over my images. I am trying not to carry ink from here to there. And all I do is to be very gentle. Therefore, as you see, I didn't have any problem with the inks moving from here to there and spoiling the image, not even in the white areas. The toucan I glued is from the toucan collection that Elena has, one that I love completely, and I created a page with all these toucans, another story. So I'm going to actually put it down below at the description area if you haven't seen it, and up in the corner so that you can have a look if you want. I'm using the Arteza paint to just create a kind of surface so that they don't look like they are floating around. I'm just using my baby wipe when I feel it's too much covering the floor. After all, I have all this texture that I created. And I'm also going to give you all the links for Arteza products, paints, if you want to buy them. I have a discount code, so you can use it. All the links again will be down below at the description area. I wrote and printed these sentiments myself with my printer from the computer. It says, "Don't make me flip out." This is called Maria, actually, this mermaid woman, but I call her Mer Maria. And I decided that this little goat who has the tail swimming like a kind of mermaid is her son, and he did something naughty and she's angry with him. So he's kind of scared, and his friends that are watching him say just keep swimming, so they leave the area, meanwhile telling you the story in my mind. I'm just drawing some bubbles to give some fun images, fun doodles, and I wrote gulp for the little boy who is called Gary. I'm just writing the names of the characters. I named the fishy Shirley, the crab is Bob, and the lobster is Danny, and I'm going to write Mer Maria for the mermaid. And of course, let's not forget the toucan. I also drew the legs, the thin legs. He's called George, and he's very happy that he can fly and watch the what's happening from far away. Anyway, that's my little story with these cute things. I just can't help myself, because when I see these are images with expressions on their faces, So I can't help creating stories in my mind, which gives me fun in my day anyway. That's the whole objective. I just decided to give some waves to create, as I said, more energy. I like to keep things more energetic, give some movement when I can. So I'm just using my hand or baby wipe to put some light blue and white waves. And I'm going to do some white splashes as well as the final thing on this page. I hope you enjoyed this page and my story. As I said, I'm going to put all the links to these beautiful images down below at the description area. And don't forget to go to the Facebook page to have the Marmaria for free. And also have fun, because Elena and all the other people there are posting very beautiful images and having fun conversations. If you like this video, also don't forget to give me a thumbs up or subscribe to my channel as well. If you want to see more fun videos with Elena's images, I have a lot, so check out my art journal playlist, and I am putting a couple here as well. Thanks so much for watching, and see you next time.